What we have in front of us here is an object sliding down an incline. Let's say there's no friction. It's accelerating at a constant acceleration, starts at initial velocity equal to zero, and reaches a certain point, let's call that x1, and it reaches that point after 5 seconds. The next 5 seconds, it continues to slide, it continues to accelerate, so it covers more and more distance in the same amount of time. So when another 5 seconds elapses, now total time is 10 seconds, it will have covered a distance of 90 meters coming from this point to that point. The question now is, how far is this distance right here? And so, in other words, how far is x1 from the initial point? How do you do that? Well, there's two ways in which we can solve that. There's an easy way, a graphical way, by simply understanding what's going on. And then, of course, there's a way in which we can use the equation of kinematics. So let's write down those equations. So we have v equals v initial plus a times t. We have v squared equals v initial squared plus 2a times the delta x. And we have x equals x sub naught plus v sub naught times time plus 1/2 a t squared. Notice that we know the acceleration is constant, we just don't know what it is. So the first way we can think about it is to first graph the equation, or at least graph what's happening here. So the velocity is increasing at a constant acceleration, and it starts at zero, so we can imagine that the velocity will increase like this. So we go v versus t, it'll look like this. And notice that after 5 seconds, it will have reached this point right there, which we call point x1. And after an additional 5 seconds, make it a little bit bigger, like that, so 10 seconds here, we will have reached a distance of x2. All right, now, in a velocity versus time graph, what does the area represent? Of course, remember, the area represents the distance traveled. So the distance traveled, and of course, I just found my mistake right here. It's not distance here. It is v1 and v2. So that's the velocity at 1, that's the velocity at 2. But it's the area underneath, it's this area right here, which represents x1. So the area equals the distance from 0, so x sub 0 to x sub 1. And this distance right here, if I draw a line this way, then what I can realize is that this area right here represents the 90 meters. And then also notice that this triangle is the same size as this triangle, so this triangle represents a distance of x1. And then if I draw a straight line across like that from corner to corner, then I realize that this triangle is the same as this triangle, and this triangle is the same as this triangle. In other words, the area underneath the curve from there to there is 3 times the area underneath the curve from there to there. So what that means is that the distance from x1 to x2 is 3 times the distance from x0 to x1. So what we can say is that x2 minus x1, that's the distance from there to there, represented by this area here, is equal to 3 times the distance from x sub 0 to x sub 1. So that would be x sub 1 minus x sub 0. And this is what we're looking for. Since x sub 0 squared is equal to 0, what I can say is that from x2 minus x1 is equal to 3 times x1, which is 3 times this distance right here, which means that x1 is equal to 1/3 the distance from x1 to x2, or x2 minus x1. Since this is 90 meters, 1/3, not 1/2, pretty messy here, 1/3 times 90 meters, and of course, that means it is 30 meters. So in a very interesting way, I can actually show that the distance from there to there is 30 meters if the distance from there to there is 90 meters and there's constant acceleration taking place. So that's done in a nice graphical way. But we should also be able to solve this problem using the equation kinematics. So what we're going to do is we're going to find the distance from 0, x sub 0 to x sub 1 in terms of the acceleration. Let's just call the acceleration a. And we're going to use this equation right here. So we have x1 is equal to x sub naught plus v sub naught times time plus 1/2 a t squared. Now notice that going from there to there took 5 seconds. We started at 0, so this goes to 0. We had initial velocity equal to 0, so I can say that x1 is equal to 1/2 times acceleration, which of course I don't know yet what that acceleration is, times 5 squared, because I knew it took 5 seconds. That's 25 divided by 2, or x of 1 is equal to 12.5 times acceleration. All right, doesn't tell us yet what it is, but at least we know that's 12.5 times acceleration. Then I can find the velocity at this point. So if I want to know that what v1 is equal to, I can use this equation and do the exact same thing. So I can say that v1 equals v sub naught plus a times t. Of course, v sub naught was 0 because it started from rest. So we can say that v1 is equal to a times 5. So in other words, v1 is equal to 5a, 5 times acceleration. So now we know what x1 is, and we know what v1 is. Now, of course, don't worry about the units. The units will take care of themselves later. So now that I know what x1 and v1 is, I can now use this equation to find what x2 is equal to in terms of x1. So you'll see in just a moment. So now we can write x2 is equal to x1 plus v sub 1 times t plus 1 half a t squared. So now I'm using this equation for this part of the motion right here. Now remember, x2 is 90 meters plus x1. So x2 is 90 meters plus x1 equals x1 plus v sub 1 times t plus 1 half a t squared. Notice that x1 cancels out on both sides. I say, well, wait a minute, isn't that what I'm looking for? And the answer is yes. But at least this will allow us to find the actual acceleration. And now once we have the acceleration, we can then go back and find x sub 1 and v sub 1. All right, so stay with me just a moment. So I'm going to drop the meters there. So 90 is equal to v1 times t. Now v1 was 5a times t. And the time that it takes to go from there to there is another 5 seconds. So t is 5 plus 1 half times a times t squared, which is, of course, 5 squared, or 25. So now we have 90 is equal to 25a plus 25 times half, or 12.5a. In other words, 90 is equal to 37.5a, or a is equal to 90 divided by 37.5. Of course, the units are meters per second squared. But let's find out what that's equal to. 90 divided by 37.5 equals, that is 2.4 meters per second squared. Now we go back over here and realize that x1 is 12.5 times that number. So x1 is equal to 12.5 times 2.4. The units, of course, will be meters. So times 12.5, and x1 is equal to 30 meters, which, of course, is what we found over here when we did it graphically. If you want to know what the velocity is at that point, we could say that v1 is equal to 5 times a, or 5 times 2.4, which is equal to 12 meters per second. So now we know the acceleration, we know the velocity after 5 seconds, and we know that it's traveled 30 meters when it gets to x1. And that's how you do it both graphically and algebraically.